So when something like hip hop comes out, yeah, you got these old wrinkly dudes, Keith Richards and the Rolling mm-hmm. Stone, like they just sampled. That's not real music. And Kiss, that's not real music. They're instruments, you know. Yeah. But Stevie Wonder, when he was sampling stuff, was that music? Of course it was.
Yeah.
But when some street kids sample, all of a sudden it's not music. You know, they're just talking. You know. So yeah, historically it'll never change, and whatever the next thing is, they go, that's not real art, you know. Mm-hmm. And porn, that's not art, that's just pornographic. It's you know, who is to decide what's art and what's not? Who's the be all end all bearer of truth? Mm-hmm. This is what art is, and because mm-hmm. I say so. who the fuck is that guy or girl or whoever, you know?
Well, some porn is art, and some porn is just people fucking on an iPhone. Some porn has an artistic angle.
So you're the guy.
I'm what
to decide.
Yeah,
I said,
why not?
Decide. Yeah, but that. Yeah, but good thing you don't have an authority, because if you had the authority to tell, that's art. This one's not. This one isn't. Yeah. This one isn't. Like, we all think we're the ones that know better than everyone else.
But when they're making porn on an iPhone for Pornhub or OnlyFans, I don't think that they think they're making art. I think the directors in porn that are like, we're going to shoot this cinema, it's going to have a story, and you frame it like a movie, and there's subtext. I think that they're thinking like,
So was Deep Throat art?
Deep Throat isn't, that's a feature porn film from the 70s, art? Right? It's probably more art than what you see on Pornhub today.
Most people in that era would go, that's not art, that's just pornographic footage. Mm-hmm. But it had a...
By that standard, the standards of the time.
Yeah. I'm saying the standard of today, maybe they'll look, oh, yeah, who the fuck knows? But I'm saying back then, they go, oh, that's just a pornographic film. But now you look, there's a story, there's actors, the camera setups, they lit it. So is it art or is it just a hardcore porn? Who, you know, that's all I'm saying.
I feel what you're saying, but I think that there's still today in the porn industry an aim by certain productions, like, we're going to make this one artistic, and then other ones were like, okay, let's fucking film it.
Okay.
Yeah, because of the way they block it like a movie.
Let me ask you something. If Lala, my DJ, makes some kind of video clip of her goofing around with Reverie, they do these like little goofy things mm-hmm. on their iPhones where, oh, I'm getting chased, and the feds are coming for us, right? Mm-hmm. But is that art? Because it's just some cheap shit they did in 1 second with their iPhone having fun. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So is that less of art than someone being like, hey, put this in my ass on this video camera. And you know what? I'm going to pretend that you're my stepmom. And they're acting. You have the camera rolling. You have the light set up. And I'm not saying it's art or not. But I'm saying, where does the line get crossed?
I think there's not between like not being art and art. I think if there's like something that's creative, I guess you can gauge like the level of skill on said art. But just because something's a little bit different of a quality.
I disagree with that too, because that, you know, there was a, goddamn, what was his name? The Boiled Angel. Frank Henelotta did a documentary mm-hmm. on the guy. And he was doing all this fucked up art in his like, comics and they arrested him. He's the only guy that got arrested ever for drawing comics, and they said that's not art. So they had to have professionals go in and say, well, who determined this? Well, the quality of the drawings aren't artistic enough to be actual art, so it's not art. So they actually had the court case. Yeah. But that's exactly what you just said almost.
No, I'm not disagreeing with your point. I'm saying that for them to say the art isn't as good, I'm saying, not saying if it's not art, if it's not good, but saying you can compare two arts and be like, this one's a little bit better, one's a little bit lower quality.
Yeah, different forms of art.
Not art, but I'm saying it's like a lower form of art. So say if you had two porn videos, one's a full cinematic film, the other one's on an iPhone, they're both art, but you can just gauge which one.
I know exactly what he's saying, and I know what you're saying.
But his comics were looked at as pornographic and not really art. And if you want to go there, you go, hey, Da Vinci or you know, mm-hmm. Picasso.
Oh, yeah.
Next to this guy that makes these fucking weird pornographic, sick, you know, blood exploitation, bad drawings. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people go, that's not art. But it is.
My argument, you know, was Da Vinci's is higher quality art and his is a different quality of art. Like his is like, yeah. So I'm saying you can gauge like, oh, that's not as artistic as this. But
and then there's more traditional art, and then maybe there's more freeform art. I think he's talking about the differences in creativity. I think what you're getting at is the way, like, take critics will be like, there are artistic pictures in movies, but an action movie can never qualify. And then you look and you go, but hold on a second. You take, like, even though people might say like an Expendables movie is stupid, you take five, six guys all in battle at the same time, a single on every one of them. You're following six dudes, six different kinds of combat. Then you put it all together. Each of them have a different fighting style. Each of them have a different like war pattern style. So it's art on some level, but
unquestionably
the
art.
Yeah, but
no, wait, it's not art.
No, yeah, no, it is. But the critics will say, like, no, there's like an artistic picture, and then that's just like fuck around shit. I think that's what you're getting at, that it's all art.
Well, I'm just saying, who determines what the quality level has to be?
I guess the critics think they do.
Yeah, but they who the fuck are they?
Yeah, but I don't think.
And take this, okay? You could take Avatar, the new fucking $400 million Avatar. Every shot is pretty, blah, 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 blah. But, and then take Cassavetes film where, you know, they don't have $500 million to make every shot perfectly beautiful, digital, boom, boom, boom. And you got shots that are dark and look like shit. And, and the performance is this, and the zoom wasn't what it needed to be. And this is out of focus a little more. And if you want to go, which is the professional art, you go this Avatar shit. But which one is the real art? Cassavetes is telling a story and speaking from the soul and speaking from the heart. And some people would say that about Avatar. I watch Avatar and be like, jerk me the fuck off. Get me out of this movie theater. To me, I'd be like, that's not fucking art. But I'm, you know, obviously it is. But yeah. I watch Avatar or one of these big fucking superhero movies. I'm like, this shit is bullshit. They gave $400 million for the same bullshit over and over again. I can't look at it. I don't like it. I don't, you know, I'd rather watch something that was shot for $300,000 by a real motherfucking person with a small, tiny crew, even though it's more, that's amateur. That's lower quality to some people. But it's not lower quality because it's
substance, it's the value.
Yeah. So it's the same thing, like you take Marley Marl, you know, would make these legendary fucking beats and rhymes, and they're still listening to them 40 years later. You know, Shan, Shantae, all of this shit, Bismarcky, Kane, all of this shit. Craig G had Tragedy, and he was making some of those records on a little 8-track player in his fucking Queensbridge apartment with no studio. And yes, or take Dr. Dre's fucking ring, ring, wrong, ding, ding. Yep. The fucking Marley Marl shit blows it out the water. But Dre has the fucking instrumentation and his clean mix. And
that was a catchy hook, man.
That hook is terrible.
I love it. You can't get it out your head. You start saying it for the rest of the day.
That shit is terrible.
Keep your heads ringing.
So I'll take a Marley Marl mixed out of the QB apartment that sounds like hip-hop. Over some, like, look how perfect every little part of it is. Woo! You know what I mean? So somebody could listen to Dre's record and go, like, that Bismarcky record is lower quality. And then anybody that's hip hop, like, suck my dick, motherfucker. Yeah. You know?
So it's the same dynamic of, like, say, if a seasoned artist was in a shitty home studio and made an album or a record, and a newer artist never made a song in his life having the opportunity to go in a beautiful studio with a beautiful producer and making a product that sounds like to the ear perfect, but the quality of the art, it wouldn't be as well as like a seasoned artist. Yeah, if that makes sense.
Yeah. And then you go to where people go, it's all opinion, whoever thinks it is and this and that, you know? So like, you can hear the worst song you ever heard in your life, and you know technically it's terrible. Mix is terrible. The artist on it sucks. All
lyrics
shit.
Blow.
And then there's fans that gravitate towards it and really love it and think it's like life-changing, and they'll go up to the, oh, you saved my life with this. And well, listen, that's the most terrible shit I've ever heard in my life. But it's not to some people. So, you know, I used to think, like, you know, you have to be this highest quality. And that I still hold myself in that for my own mental. Because if I put out some really lower level whack technique and blah, 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 I couldn't live with myself. But a lot of people do. And they do a lot better than I do. And they do a lot better than all my goats do. So it is what it is for who the fuck wants whatever.
So I got the perfect question to wrap up this segment, and then I want to talk about you. Is mumble rap art then?
Yes, it is.
No
it
shit. Is. Mumble. Yes, it is. Just hubba-da, hubba-da, hubba-da.
After that conversation, I mean, yeah.
You think it's art too?
In the topic of the conversation we just had, where it doesn't matter if we like it or not, if you think it's good or bad, like any type of creativity would be considered like an art.